Hi everyone, I am back with another seascape tutorial. I'll be using poster colors for this one and it's going to be a fun and experimental experience. I hope you enjoy it as much as I did while creating this. And if you do, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Let's start. I'll be painting in a sketchbook today, and this is the Stillman and Burns sketchbook, which has three colored pages. These are gray, beige and black. And I'm using Camel Premium poster colors. Here are my two jars of water and I'll be using acrylic paint brushes. To paint the sky, we are taking Persian blue color and some white, and we'll create a very light blue shade. Apply this color starting from the top and make a rectangle kind of a shape, but the lower edge should be slanting. Now add more white and create a lighter shade. Then apply it in the same manner as before. Now mix white and yellow ochre or mustard and apply a thin layer. Take a wet and clean brush and merge all of these colors. Take chrome yellow with a little bit of white and mix these two. Then again, apply a very thin layer, leaving a little bit of space in between for the sun. Merge these two colors too with a wet and clean brush. For the sun, take clean white paint and draw a shape just similar to Jupiter. Then merge that particular shape with the rest of the colors using a clean and wet brush. Enhance the sun with more white paint and some rays coming out of it. Create sea green color using Persian blue, white and green. Use this shade to cover both the sides of the sea, leaving a little bit of space in between. Mix a little ochre yellow in that same color and fill in the space. Using the same color, apply it to the bottom part of the sea in the shape of a triangle. Then again, use clean wet brush to merge both the colors. Now mix ochre yellow with burnt sienna and make the sand of the beach. Also, don't forget to merge the colors of the sea and the sand using a wet clean brush. Mix white, green and blue to create a dark shade. Then make some waves in the sea. You can add some white to the same shade to create more highlights. Use clean and wet brush to merge all of this. Now, take white paint and draw a slanting squiggly line in the shape of a sea wave touching the shore. To add foam to the sea wave, add random strokes in whichever way you like. Now, add some dark blue strokes on this particular sea wave and try to enhance that area. And merge these colors with a wet and clean brush. You You can add some ochre yellow on the other side of the C wave and repeat the same process. Take black and add shadows to your C waves. Now, following the placement of the sun, add some sunshine on the sea. Now, take a bright yellow and try to outline them. Merge these two with a clean wet brush and then add more white highlights. Mix black and blue and create clouds using that shade. Just dab the tip of your brush in an irregular shape. Use a clean wet brush to merge all of this with the background. Mix white, yellow, and burnt sienna and add more clouds. Then merge all of them with the background. To add more shadow to the sand, use more burnt sienna. Use a darker shade of blue to enhance the clouds and merge it with the rest of the base. And your fun seascape with some edgy strokes is now complete. If you like this video, do mention it in the comment section below and don't forget to subscribe for more such tutorials. Bye!